Anderson, you just hit it right on the head there. The only two things you really need to know about this election and maybe next fall's too, the economy and independence. In the past 24 hours, that has grown more and more clear as we've crunched the numbers. Republicans won key races in Virginia and New Jersey last night, the same way Barack Obama won those states last year, by cashing in on voters who want change, especially in the economy. Look at what voters were thinking here. 63% of Americans think that things are going badly right now. 64% are angry about it. 65% are scared. And 75% are stressed by all of this. Last year, those people flocked to Barack Obama's promise of better days. In Virginia, 77% of those voters went Republican this time. And in New Jersey, 61% of those voters went Republican. Democrats have spent all day long, as you heard there, trying to shrug off these numbers. But small as this sample is, this is clearly a warning shot that a lot of people here in D.C. are taking seriously, Anderson.
As well as they should. Tom, how big was the shift among independents?
Well, it's a really interesting point that you raise there, Anderson, because Mr. Obama had 52% of independent votes in the election last time, and he just edged out John McCain for those votes in these two states. But in this election, in both places, the GOP grabbed more than 60% of the independent votes. Remember, the president campaigned for the Democratic candidates in both of these places, and they both lost. That looks bad no matter how you slice it. It's also made Republicans significantly more excited about voting next fall than Democrats are, and all day we've heard them crowing about their new momentum. That matters too, Anderson, because turnout can make a huge difference.
And what did voters actually say? In their opinion, was this a referendum on Barack Obama's presidency?
No, this is interesting, Anderson. On his presidency, no. We've looked this over carefully, and voters told us that if you look at the totality of it, this was not about Mr. Obama. And Democrats did win congressional races in New York and California. Here's the thing. People like President Obama still, but they don't like his economic policies, certainly not as much. And all signs say this was a bit of a vote on that record. We ask people, who will you blame if the economy does not get better in the next 12 months? President Bush and the Republicans over here, or President Obama and the Democrats? A year ago, overwhelmingly, the answer was President Bush and the Republicans. Now, 47% say they'll blame the Republicans. And look at this. 45% say they will blame the Democrats. This is a big, big change. Bottom line, this election was a kind of test case, but the results are real. Once again, angry independents, what I've always called the militant middle, are on the warpath. And their message to Democrats and Republicans is get something done or get out. And if this economy remains in trouble, Anderson, incumbents in both parties, you can bet, will pay next fall.
All right, Tom, thanks. New Jersey, Virginia, we're one.